No, I'm not crying. Hey guys, what's up? JLZ back again, and a reminder. One like equals one prayer for a Vikings fan in need near you. Well, let's get to the top 10 replacement options for Dalvin Cook. And this isn't going to be different. This isn't going to be we're going to trade a first-round pick for... We're not going to trade for, you know, Ezekiel Elliott or anybody like that. This is a trade for a number 2 or number 3 guy to fill in the gap that Dalvin Cook's missing. We'd like to get the same skill package, and it'll be grading each of these players on a star base out of 5. And number 1's going to be cost. How much we have to pay to get them or trade to get them, their skill level, and the overall likelihood of the scenario happening. So now, let's look from number 10, my least likely, number 1, the one I want the absolute most. Number 10, could you believe it? He'd be back, Purple Jesus, back where he belongs in Minnesota. Adrian Peterson is back, baby. Could you believe it? So, this all comes down to the fact that Adrian Peterson has struggled mightily in New Orleans, and I don't think he's liking it there. And if it's true that he really isn't liking it there, he's going to start out a little mess in the clubhouse. Maybe the Sean Payton is going to want to dump him. What a better place to dump him than back where he belongs. Yes, he's going to come back to Mike Zimmer and see if Rick Spielman has any return policy on unwanted trash. No, well, it's Purple Jesus. It's like old trash, right? It's like a VHS tape. We're going to look at Adrian Peterson, and he has been kind of god-awful this year. He is at 27 attempts for 81 yards. That's a 3 average, and that's what he's doing all day. So, all day, more like all done. But could he be back in Minnesota? And this would be interesting because if he is trouble in the clubhouse, they just might want to dump him just to get him off the roster. And if he can't cut him, maybe trade him to Minnesota. So this one would be an interesting trade. The way this scenario would go is, number 1, the Vikings would trade someone that we don't need anymore, like Jarius Wright. With Michael Floyd coming back, wide receivers are expendable. So send Jarius Wright to New Orleans, we get Adrian Peterson, and they'd have to sugar it up a little bit with like a 6th or 7th round pick, and then we talk in. So that's a trade I would like to see. And bring Adrian back, how good would he be with us? Not very, which brings us to our stars. His stars are being cost, gonna be low, it's gonna be 1 star. Skill, I'll give it 2, because we know Adrian still got some in him, but I don't think a whole lot. Likelihood, I'll give this 1 as well, because I don't think we'll be wanting him, but it's just intriguing, right? So, number 9, the most Rick Spielman of them all, not do a single thing. We already have, technically, 3 active running backs on the roster. What we do, we have CJ Ham, he's plugged in at fullback, but he can be that emergency back and spare number 3 back if we need it. This would be an interesting thing because we wouldn't need to do a single thing. CJ Ham's a capable runner for a number 3 back, and he can be a fullback and give him a lot of value and not have to give up absolutely anything. So, and wouldn't change the roster whatsoever. Very safe play, and rightfully so. So, cost 0 stars, doesn't cost a dime. Skill, I'll give this one a 1 on the skill, and likelihood, I'll say a 1 as well, because I do think they'll want to get a replacement option in there, but I think it is, you have to go to the point that CJM is an option for that number 3 guy, and keep a roster spot open if you want to keep 6 wide receivers. Number 8. Bring up Bronson Hill from the practice squad. Another sneaky little move by Slick Rick. We know we liked him enough to keep him on the practice squad, so why not let him see what he can do on the active roster? This would be another really cheap play. It wouldn't cost the Vikings much at all. Hill would get a little bit more money because he would be on active roster squad and not the practice squad as far as getting his paycheck. But the Vikings wouldn't get a whole lot. We know what he'll have. He'll have good chemistry with the team because he's been on the roster. So this one's going to be a little bit better. But again, not a whole lot on the whole skill level thing. So we're going to go cost on this one. Again, we'll just go 0. Even though he'll get a little bit more, that won't really affect our salary cap. Skill level, 1. Likelihood, we'll go 2. If we don't have any other free agents are too expensive, which they really shouldn't be, It is fairly likely that we could get Bronson Hill and just bring him up to the roster. At least for the time being, I think it's a decent option. Number 7. The first free agent on this list, and that is bringing in Tim Hightower, the longtime Arizona Cardinal running back. He used to spend some time with New Orleans and Washington as well. Tim Hightower, his yards per carry average for his career is 4. His best year, his rookie year, he had 10 touchdowns. In 2009, his sophomore year, he had 8, then 5. Then when he went to other systems, he was pretty garbage. But you're looking at a guy that could be a decent number 3 guy and could even compete with Jerick McKinnon for the number 2 slot. Do we really need another veteran running back? Well, it's kind of up to you. I don't think he's that great, but it's not too bad overall. I'll give him 2s across the board. His cost is a 2. You won't have to pay him a whole lot. His skill, a 2. He's an okay veteran running back, but again, likelihood, I'll give it a 2 as well, even though he's probably just as likely as about everybody else on this list. Now, the most interesting pick I have on this whole list is numbering that is next, and that is Charkindick West, the running back that is currently on the Chiefs. Now, this kid has a lot of potential, and I think he would be a trade bait because the Chiefs have 2 running backs on the depth chart ahead of him. He's got a ton of talent. They can get something for him. This is a wide receiver needy team, so I think a straight-up trade for Jarius Wright for West would be very interesting. He's 26 years old, and he's got some pop. His career rushing stats are only a 3.8 per carry average, but his rookie year he had 634 yards and 4 touchdowns, looked really good then, and he's only fumbled once in his entire career, where he's had over 250 attempts. He's shown solid hands out of the backfield, but his numbers have been declining because they've had more running backs ahead of him. So this would be a guy that could see as an easy trade bait. Give us our trash for your trash, and he'll be our number 3 back. I think talent-wise, he's probably the most talented running back we could probably get at this moment. So I would give total skill a 4. Cost-wise, since it would be a trade, I'd have to bring that up to a 4 as well. So not looking very good there, which means brings the likelihood down to a 1 star. But it's intriguing. I think any players like that, they could trade up trade someone like Jarius Wright for, would be good. Because, you know, Jarius Wright's not going to be isn't going to be on the team for very long. A lot of fans had him cut at the end of training camp. And if Michael Floyd wasn't suspended, he probably wouldn't be on the team right now. But who knows? Next on the list, former Packer James Starks, their playoff hero a few years back. And he is very interesting as well because he's done third down reps for Green Bay. So if we saw Jet McKinnon drop the third down pass last week, we saw Latavius Murray struggle so far this year, even though I think he should be a good third down back. James Starks is a good push for him, and he should come in at a fairly cheap price. His average on his career is a 4.1, and he's shown capable hands out of the backfield like you would have to have if you're catching passes from Aaron Rodgers, as he's had some pretty decent receiving yards last year. Had 134 receiving yards for 7.1 average. And so he's capable. He's a decent dual threat back, and he'll be a good number 2 or number 3 back, and for a cheap price. And the Packer and the Vikings, for some reason, like going after these ex-Packers. So let's go and look at this. Skill-wise, I will say a 2. Cost, a 1. Likelihood, we'll go with a 4, because he's a Packer and the Vikings love their ex-Packers. Next, everybody's favorite ex-Lion. The Vikings' the number 1 running back for the Vikings for the last 5 years. You know him. You love him. Matt Asiata. Yes, could you imagine Matt Asiata coming back in purple? So many fans just hate this guy. But man, this guy's a hard worker that can get you into the end zone if Latavius Murray's ankle's bugging him, so he doesn't quite have the goal line power that we want. Matt Asiata's perfect for that. He's not going to break long ones. but he's a good third down back. He played more than Jarrett McKinnon last year. Remember that. When we did the dual back threat, it was Matt Asiata, then Jarrett McKinnon. So I think that shows that we like him. He went to the Lions this year, so that means other teams, but at least the Lions, thought he was good enough to give him a chance. He got cut at the end of camp, and now he's ready to go again. So it's Matt Asiata. Career average, you guys know it, 3.5 yards average. If you need 3 yards, he'll give you 3 yards. If you need 5 yards, he'll give you 3 yards. That is Matt Asiata. He's constant downhill, 3 yards. He's not going to put the ball on the ground a lot, only 3 fumbles in his entire career. And he's a decent catch the ball guy. He had 312 receiving yards in 2014, and a touchdown, his only receiving touchdown of his career. He's a decent back. You guys can give him all the crap you want, but Matt Asiata is a decent back. And for a number 3 back, it's solid, and he likes Minnesota, so I think this would be one of the most likely ones that could possibly happen. So let's go back to the star chart and go cost. We'll go 1. Skill, a 2, but likelihood, I almost want to go 5 here. Let's go 5 for likelihood. I think this is one of the most likely ones we could possibly do, because Matt Asiata knows the system. He could very well get signed today and know the playbook almost off the bat. It hasn't been changed a whole lot since last year. Matt Asiata makes a ton of sense to come in and be the number 3 or even number 2 back. I think he's a solid back that gets too much flack for not being flashy. But just run between the tackles, give us 3 or 4 yards, we'll take it. So there is Matt Asiata. Now we're getting in the top 3 category. Next is another veteran, Rashad Jennings, the ex-Giant. His career rushing stats, a 4.1 average. His best year came just 2 years ago in New York, where he had 864 yards, a 4.4 average, only 3 touchdowns though. So you'd like a little bit more, but he's a guy that can come in and be a decent number 2 back, I would say, and maybe even compete with Latavius Murray and push him a little bit. So Rashad Jennings, I would think his cost would be up a little bit higher, but he's a free agent. Nobody really wanted him, so I would just give him 2 stars for cost. Say his skill level, is as far as these guys go, is a 3, and likelihood is a 3. He's a solid back that can come in here and play solid. That's all we really need, is a guy that can fill in. Next, the oldest guy here, the vet, D'Angelo Williams, number 2. And man, is this guy interesting, because he's a grinder, but it's how much left does he have in the tank? D'Angelo Williams, the 34-year-old running back, longtime Carolina Panther, and from the last 2 years with the Steelers. He came in the league in 2006, and he's still kicking. So is he good for any 11th year? Well, we'll see. His stats have been solid throughout his whole career, really. He has a 4.7 yards per carry average. He has 61 career touchdowns. He had 11 touchdowns 2 years ago, and that sounds a lot like Latavius Murray. So if you want a 1-2 punch, I can both get in the end zone. Both can run between the tackles, give you some tough flow of yardage. I think it's an interesting option. Just 2 years ago, 4.5 average, and he spent time with Carolina, where he had over 5 yards per carry average. So D'Angelo Williams, he's old and wouldn't really cost a lot. I think he might want to come to Minnesota just to get that ring if he thinks the Vikings have a chance to go. We'll put cost at a 3 here, because he is the older veteran. He would probably have to do a little bit more. Skill-wise, he's so tough to say, because because he is so old. You don't know how much he has left in the tank, a lot like Adrian Peterson. But I would give him a 3 there. He could be a 4 or a 2, really, but we'll go 3 right between. Likelihood, I'll give this one a 4. He's so old that I think we might go ahead and get it. Next on this list, number 1. The one you guys have all been looking forward to. A guy that not a lot of fans like in Philly, Ryan Matthews. Spending time with Sam Bradford and the Vikings offensive coordinator in Philadelphia could give him some connection status to come here right away. And he really hasn't been very bad. His career running average is 4.4 yards a carry. He ran for 661 yards last year and 8 touchdowns. You're looking at a guy that can come in and be a decent little workhorse for us if you wanted to do some more split back carries with him and Latavius Murray, especially when we don't know how well Latavius Murray's ankle's going to be holding up. He was a first round back in 2010, 12th overall. He's got talent to be a great running back. It's how we use him, if we use him well. He had 2,000 yard seasons, but overall been fairly disappointing. But he's shown capable of catching the ball out of the backfield. In 2011 in San Diego, he had 455 receiving yards. You're looking at a guy that can be a decent dual threat running back, which is kind of what Dalvin Cook gave us. So as far as all around skill, as far as free agent running back this time of year, I have no choice but to give him a 5. You guys might give him some flack because he didn't look too good in Philly, but he's got all the talent in the world, and it's hard to say that, man, we could bring him in and he could look fairly good right off the hop. Likelihood, I'll also give a 4, because even though he has a few connections, a little bit with Bradford, not a lot, it could help a little bit, and more than usual, and he's got some age under him as well. And cost is a 3, a little bit younger on the running back pole, but won't cost a whole lot regardless. So there we have it, our quick recap. Adrian Peterson, 10. 9, CJ Ham, aka nothing. Bronson Hill, number 8. Tim Hightower, 7. Charnion Dick West, 6. James Stark, 5. And the top 5, we have Matt Asiata, number 4. We have Rashad Jennings, number 3. Number 2 is D'Angelo Williams. And the number 1 running back I have is Ryan Matthews coming in from Philly. And he's currently a free agent and he could be a good fit for the Vikings offense and fill in some needs. And he has a lot of talent. I want to know what you guys think in the comment section. And hopefully Dalvin Cook gets back and looks better than ever. He was on pace to be Rookie of the Year. I don't care what the Chiefs running back's doing. Dalvin Cook's going to be the consistent guy that was going to go 1,100 yards and like 500 receiving yards. Too much for that. But Latavius Murray should pick up the slack and look fairly good. As long as ankle injury isn't as worse than what we thought, he should be very good still. So don't put too much past Latavius Murray. He's still looking at an 8 touchdown year for him. So Latavius Murray should still be good. One of the other guys should fill in nicely as well. So there we have it. We'll see you guys in the next JOZ Vikings video.